Please subscribe our channel Education Point and press bell icon to get notification of new educational videos.
Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 253, and today I am going to discuss the process of extraction of elements. And when I am saying of element, please, it is divided into two. One is metallic elements and the other one is non-metallic elements. And metallic elements are those elements which are capable of losing the electrons, they are electropositive. And the properties of metallic elements is that they are malleable, they are ductile, and they form luster. Malleable means they can be hammered into sheet. Secondly, they are ductile means they can be drawn into thin wire. And they form luster means they have shining color. So these are the properties of metallic elements in periodic table. And these metallic elements, they are also having some properties, like they are good conductor of heat and good conductor of electricity. And the example of metallic elements are alkaline elements, alkaline earth elements like lithium, sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium, etc. And rest are non-metallic elements. Non-metallic elements mean they are electronegative. They are not electropositive. They have tendency of losing the electron. And they are not malleable. They are not ductile. They cannot be drawn into wire. They are brittle. They cannot be hammered into sheet. And they are not shining. They have rough color. So these are the two type of elements. And these elements, these chemical compounds, which are present in earth crust, and by the process of mining, once they are removed, and such compounds or substances in the form of element is known as mineral. And these minerals, when they are going to isolate some commercially important, economically important means which can bring money, then those minerals are known as ores. So the mineral and ore, they are the same. Only thing is difference is that ore means those minerals which are having commercial value, economic value. They can be sold, they can bring the money. That's why they are known as ores. And these ores, they are associated with lot of earthy impurities. And those impurities from earth, they are called as gangue. And mainly, there are two processes of extracting or isolating of the metal and non-metal elements only by either reduction or oxidation. Means either by addition of the electron or by removal of the electron. So your most of the metals, they are isolated, extracted in pure form by reduction, and your non-metals, they are by oxidation, means some of the electrons are removed, like chloride ion, with the help of electrolysis, electroplating. Lot of methods are there by means of which once electron is removed, chloride ion is oxidized into chlorine, and then you will get the chlorine. So these are all the process. And then I have given some very, very important elements in atmosphere and on earth, which are playing very important role in our daily life. For example, like oxygen, which is 49.7%, silicon. So all these are there. So silicon, aluminium, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. And let me give you a very interesting thing about hydrogen and oxygen. You know, hydrogen is the smallest element with only one electron, one proton, very small size. And it is highly explosive. And it is used as a rocket fuel. And oxygen is helping in burning. You might have done that experiment that if any candle is burning and if you cover with any glass, after 1 minute or a few seconds, it will stop burning because there is no enough supply of oxygen. So oxygen helps in burning and hydrogen burns. So both are explosive, I mean in the sense of one is helping to burn and one is burning. And when these two they combine together, we get H2O. That is water. And water can be used to put off the fire. So this is the beauty of the chemistry and all these elements in combined form and in elemental form. And there are a lot of elements. They are known as biological elements. They play an important role in our plant and animal life. For example, iron is the part of our hemoglobin. Zinc is the part of some enzymes. And some other important elements are there which are playing very important role. So I am giving all this one by one. So here the first one is that is process of extraction of elements. The naturally occurring chemical substances in the earth's crust which are obtained by mining are known as minerals. Number two, the minerals from which the elements are extracted economically or profitably are termed as ores. Number three, ores are usually associated with earthy materials as impurities called gangue. Number four, the modern technologies used for extracting metals from their ores is called metallurgy. Three major steps are used for the extraction of the metal. Number one is the concentration of the ores. Number two, that is isolation of the metals. And number three, that is purification of the metal. 16 most abundant elements in the earth's crust. So these 16 are most abundant in earth crust. First is oxygen, the atomic number 8, and percentage is 49.5. Then number 2 is silicon, that is 14 atomic number, and 25.7 percentage by weight. And this earth is actually, if you go anywhere, you will get silicon dioxide. So silicon is, we can call it, earth is a silicon planet. Everywhere there is silicon in combined state. Then number 3 is aluminium, atomic number 13, and percentage by weight is 7.5. Number 4 is iron, 26 atomic number, 4.7%. Number 5, calcium, atomic number is 20, 3.4%. Sodium, atomic number 11, 2.6%. Potassium, 19 atomic number, and 2.4%. Then magnesium, 12 atomic number, and 1.9%. Number 9, hydrogen, atomic number 1, smallest one. And the percentage by weight is 0.9. Number 10, titanium, atomic number 22, and percentage by weight 0.6. Then number 11, chlorine, atomic number is 17, 0.2%. Then phosphorus, atomic number 15, and by percentage is 0.1. Then manganese, atomic number 25, and percentage by weight is 0.09. Then 14 carbon, atomic number 6, and 0.08% by weight. Sulfur, atomic number 16, 0.06% by weight, and number 16 is, that is barium, atomic number 56, and percent by weight is 0.04. So here I am giving some list of the most important elements which play important role in plant and animal, that is biological organism. And the first most important element is carbon. Carbon is the building block of all carbohydrates, cellulose, protein, amino acid, fat, which is very important for animal as well as plant. So carbon is the most important. So here number one is carbon is essential constituent of all living organisms. Number two is iodine is intimately associated with seaweeds. Number three, vanadium is found in sea cucumber. Number four, potassium is an essential constituent of plants. Potassium is very important in plants because if there is deficiency of potassium, your seed shining will not be there. Like wheat or maize or anyone. And then number five is the presence of iron in hemoglobin. So the iron in hemoglobin is responsible of making red color. And magnesium in chlorophyll is responsible of making the green color. So this magnesium and iron, they are the part of animal and plant. Number six, zinc is found in enzymes and cells of eyes. Number seven, manganese, iron and copper are the constituents of chloroplasts. Number eight, oceans is also a rich source of a number of elements like sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium, strontium, and metals like gold and manganese are found in sediments of ocean floor. And here I am going to give some hint of the extraction of non-metallic elements. The metallic elements, I have already discussed the extraction, that is called metallurgy. If you check my previous lecture, the whole metallurgy, the ore, their formulae is given. So here I will be discussing the non-metallic elements. So I have already told you non-metallic element like chlorine, if you want to extract, it is by the process of electrolysis, where some compounds are there and they will take away the electron and chloride will be oxidized into chlorine molecules. So the extraction of non-metallic elements, it is extracted by oxidation. For example, 2Cl chloride ion in aqueous form plus 2H2O, you will get 2OH minus plus H2 gas plus Cl2 gas. The oxidation of chloride cannot be carried out by ordinary chemical method. This can be achieved only by electrolysis. And similarly, the fluorine is also extracted by the same method, electrolysis. So with this, I will stop. Thank you very much.